This is Match Game 74, production number 0175. Air date to be announced, VTR 3274. Take one. Get ready to match the stars. At Harrington, Brett Summers, Nipsey Russell, Fanny Flay, Richard Dawson, and Joanne Worley. As we play the star-studded Big Money Match Game 74. And now, here's the host of Match Game 74, Gene Rayburn.
Stand up. Come on now, tell me about it.
Well, I have to rush to a meeting. My girls and I, we're having a taped message from Debbie Reynolds on how to sell cookies. Yes. And I just got dressed, and I just have to rush right out of the studio.
You got the cold drinks down in the creek?
You're putting us on.
No, Brett used to be a member of my troupe, and we make pins. Brett is wearing a pin that we made in our troupe.
All right, you got to zoom in on Brett's pin.
Would anybody like to see my pin? Yeah. Now, she told me I should make rust, something with UST on the end. So I made lust. It's a lust pin.
You can all see that.
Now, it rhymes with bust.
Yeah, that's enough.
Must. Start a fire by rubbing two Boy Scouts together.
You're going to be all right. Just 4 or 5 months in a sanitarium, and we'll book you back on the show there. Hello, Michael Schmidt. Here's our current champ, Michael Schmidt. There.
Thank you.
How are you?
Fine. How are you?
Good. He's won $700. He won $700, old Michael did. Do you know Michael won $700? How do you feel about that?
Fantastic.
Gee, you got another fancy outfit. You dress better than I do. Is that another rented outfit?
It sure is.
It is, huh? I have to buy mine there. Well, listen, you won the last game, and we ran out of time when it was time to play the Big Money Super Match. I'm going to do that right after we do a little business with all of you folks out in television land. We're all set now to play for the big money here. You ready?
I'm ready.
Okay, now you know how this goes, Michael. You've been here before. We polled a recent studio audience, and we got their best response to this. Head blank. The answer they gave most often is worth $500 to you if you match it. Second most frequent response, $250. And the third, $100 if you match that one. A little help from our celebrities over here. You may choose them.
Joanne.
How do you feel on that?
Oh, a headache.
Headache. Oh, yeah. So, all right, there's one.
Richard.
Richard, what do you say?
I say I love you, Gene.
No, I mean, in regard to a head blank.
Head over heels.
Head over heels. You really do love me, don't you?
I certainly do. You're a beautiful human being. And you're a hamburger.
One more.
Fanny.
Fanny.
What do we have, headache?
We've got headache and we've got head over heels.
Okay. I'll say head cold.
Head cold. So those are the three. Head over heels, headache, and head cold. You can choose one of those or give us one of your own, but right now we need an answer.
Well, the first thing that came to my mind was headache, so I'll go with headache like Joanne.
Okay, the one that Joanne Lurley gave you. All right, we'll see if it's up there. Headache anywhere along the line will be a winner for you. First, may we see the $100 response? Headstrong is a good response. Okay. No headache yet. And now, the $250 response. Head start.
That was mine.
Got some great answers from your celebrities there, didn't you, pal? There. Boy. All right, last chance for the headache. I hope you get one. Here's the $500 response. Headache, you got it. Congratulations. There's another winner for you.
Thank you, Joanne.
Well done. Okay. Now, Michael, you know that you've won the $500. It means you'll be playing for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. You know the words by heart. You know you've got to match one celebrity head-to-head. It has to be exact. Which one will it be?
I think I'll try Fanny.
Really?
Okay. I don't blame you.
The rest of the town has tried Fanny. Why not you?
All right, sit down now. So you're going for the hamburger, eh? Okay, Fanny, you get ready to write. You face me if you would please, Michael. Here is the $5,000 question. Gypsy blank. Gypsy blank. Okay, she's finished. Now, Michael, we need a response from you. How do you fill in that blank? Gypsy
Rose Lee.
Gypsy Rose Lee. Okay, Fanny, for $5,000, may we see your answer, please?
She was a very dear friend of mine, but I put Gypsy Band.
Gypsy Band.
Band?
All right, just for that, I'm going to tear off your epaulets, and you're going to get drummed out of the Corps.
And I'm going to give you back my lost pen.
Okay.
I'm going to call Count Basie.
So, Michael, you're the champ, the continuing champ, and you've got $1,200 to your credit, and you're going to play another game, and it's going to be against Cindy Dell'Amico. Hello, Cindy. Step up here on the merry-go-round. You know Cindy. Cindy, you know Michael?
Sure do.
How are you?
Fine, how are you?
I'm very well. Thank you for asking.
Good.
Did I say your name correctly?
You sure did.
Dell'Amico.
Right.
It's a pretty name. Tell us more about yourself.
I live in Los Angeles, and I fly for an airline.
You do?
Uh-huh.
You have pretty dark eyes.
Thank you.
Ochichardnia over here. Very pretty lady. All right, good luck to you, Cindy. And good luck to you, Michael. I'll push the button, and we'll begin the game and ask you, the challenger, to make a selection there.
I'll try A.
You'll try A. Okay, here it is. This is A. Are you ready?
Talk about overstimulated.
Here's a letter. I got a letter for you. Dear Match Game 74. Mm-hmm. I love it when your panelists give dumb answers. And I think the dumbest answers come from blank. I shall refrain from making any comment or giving any sign or looking in any direction. All right. You let me know when the celebrities are finished writing, would you please, Ira? Are they all finished? Have they finished? They are finished now. Okay, Cindy. Here's a letter. Dear Match Game 74, I love it when your panelists give dumb answers, and I think the dumbest answers come from...
Oh, I hope I don't make an enemy. Brett. Oh.
Remember, you're a professional. You're a professional.
Well, you can't. Well,
I don't know, but it was a little too quick for my taste there. What do you say, Cindy? Brett was your answer there. Yes, Brett is the answer she's looking for. What'd you say?
You can't believe how wrong a guy can be.
Brett. So, Brett.
He didn't even spell my name right.
That's right. But
they know who I mean.
Yeah, they got the idea.
I'm insulted, I'm horrified, I'm shocked.
You're
and
also braged.
Yes. I'm also braged.
Yes. All right. Nipsey.
Well, on one side I said Brett, and on the other side I said amen.
Okay, that's true for you, Cindy. And now how about you?
I wouldn't hurt that woman's feelings for the world. Brett!
Brett! All right.
I'll get him.
Here's the Lone Ranger. Guy, he's been around a long time.
I have had the pleasure of working with that darling dummy for a long time. And she does not mean to be dumb. It just turns out that way.
And it's Brett. Yeah. All right, we're up to five, Cindy. How about you?
Joanne, don't betray me.
It is very rude. I sincerely mean this. The way you have ganged up on this lovely woman.
Uh-oh.
Uh-oh. When sitting next to her is the stupid Italian. He has really been dumb this week.
She not only was wrong about him not being stupid, okay. He's not Italian.
That's the most ridiculous thing I've ever.
Pat Harrington is Italian?
Well, you know, kind of.
Oh,
the junior
I see.
Part.
Oh, I see. All right, so Cindy, it's five for you, and we'll get to your question in a moment, but right now we've got to get to this, friends, so you come right back and see what's going to happen.
GSN presents Behind the Blank. In what year did Gene Rayburn appear on an episode of Fantasy Island? Was it 1975, 1979, 1982, or 1985? The answer in a minute. In what year did Gene Rayburn appear on an episode of Fantasy Island? The answer is C, 1982. If you guessed a different year, maybe you were having a fantasy all of your own. Stay tuned for more of that 70s hour on GSN.
Here we go. With Michael Schmidt's question. Are you ready, Michael?
I'm ready.
All right, then pay attention because I'm going to ask you the question later.
I'm going to smarten up from now on.
Okay, Joe said to Ted, what's 12 feet long, weighs 3 tons, and looks like a snail? Ted said, I don't know. And Joe said, I don't know either. But it's blanking your Volkswagen. It's 12 feet long, weighs 3 tons, looks like a snail. Well, you know all that.
Yeah.
Ted said, I don't know. Joe said, I don't know either, but it's blanking your Volkswagen. I say Volkswagen because we got Michael Schmidt on the program there.
Because you're
most
Hungarian.
People say Volkswagen, sir.
Hi, sweetheart.
You ready? Nipsey and Pat. Are you ready, Nipsey? Okay.
I can't read his writing.
All right. They're all ready.
I can't either.
Now, Michael, we ask you. Joe said to Ted, what's 12? You know all the rest of that. And Joe said, I don't know either, but it's blanking your Volkswagen.
Crushing your Volkswagen?
Crushing. Michael Schmidt said crushing.
Another crushing defeat for Pat, who said eating.
You know.
Go on.
You know, for a guy who gives pretty good answers, mostly.
Mostly.
You haven't matched anybody over there, hardly. You're yeah. Okay, Pat. You really got stick-to-itiveness.
Yeah. I've been this way all week.
Have you thought of getting out of show business?
Yes. Yeah, Thursday. Yesterday.
Brett, what do you say?
I say I feel sorry for the poor devil.
Eating is a good answer.
Eating is a good answer?
Yeah, crushing was not bad. Eating is a good answer. Go ahead.
It doesn't matter. So it doesn't matter if
that's
it's
right.
A good answer. I said blocking.
Blocking. Okay.
Well, I'd rather have booze than total silence.
Yeah. Nipsey, what
blocking?
Did you say?
What well, do you standing say? Standing in front of. See, he doesn't even know.
Yeah,
what
sorry, don't explain it. Go ahead,
this
Nipsey.
Man with a master's degree can say what he did. I can say dragging your wagon.
Dragon, your wagon. Okay, and how about you, ma'am?
I said eating. I'm sorry, Mike.
Eating. All right, he says, Joe said, I don't know either, but it's blanking your Volkswagen. What did you say,
said,
Richard?
I don't know either, but it's loving your Volkswagen.
All right, crushing is the answer that Michael's looking for, Joanne.
Sorry, darling, I said kissing.
Kissing. So at the end of round, it's one. It's 5-0 in favor of our challenger, Cindy DeLamico. Now we go to round two and ask Cindy to make a selection there.
I'll stick with A.
A. Now the only person who plays is Joanne Worley. This is for you only, my dear.
Oh, I'm so
you're the
nervous.
Only one.
Because you were too light, polite to insult. Brett.
Right. Here you are. You ready?
Yes.
Okay. When old Charlie celebrated his 97th birthday. They gave him a cake in the shape of a blank. There it is, my dear.
90th birthday in the shape of...
They gave him a cake in the shape of a...
How you doing? Okay.
Okay, now don't let... Now leave her alone. It's up to her. Now.
Who's guessing? The man is guessing? This is important.
No, Cindy. Cindy. Don't be influenced by anybody. Just trust your own instinct and judgment.
Here's my card if you're ever in the valley.
Thank you very much. Oh, I didn't know you had all those degrees. You ready?
I'm afraid so.
Okay,
oh, no,
Cindy.
No.
When old Charlie celebrated his 97th birthday, they gave him a cake in the shape of a...
lady.
Oh! A lady. All right, Joanne.
Well... does part of a lady, a boob, count? Well, this is the raciest thing I could...
I know.
A man would...
I gotta say to you, it counts, but not here. Answers that just didn't happen to be on the same wavelength, and we'll get to your question, Michael, right after we get to you. Take a break.
Today's consolation prizes are the Weekender by American Tourister, designed to go everywhere by land, sea, or air. Fiberglass reinforced construction, strong, lightweight luggage by American Tourister. And Profile, with its own great flavor from a special formula, cracked wheat and wheat germ just right for toast. Profile, it's a matter of taste. And Purina Variety Menu, 20 varieties, and 95% of whatever the label says, plus 5% vitamins and nutrients. No fillers added, Purina Variety Menu. We'll be serving more choice flanks on Match Game 74 in just a minute.
Go with the second and final round, the second half of it, Michael. It's up to you. You've got a tough job ahead for you here. You've got to score 5 matches to stay in the game. If you have a perfect round and match every celebrity, you will win the game. This is it. I'm going to ask you, Richard, if you'll read this, which a voice I love to hear you do, a la Robert Newton, you know, the fellow who played. Yeah, you remember.
As Long John Silver was addressing the crew, his parrot blanked into his ear.
Thank you. Well done. Bravo. Just in case. As Long John Silver was addressing the crew, his parrot blanked into his ear. Okay? You got it.
Discard the first thought.
Okay, Joanne's ready and Pat's ready. Now, we're ready down here. Waiting for Nipsey.
Is it getting to be drudgery, Gene?
No.
Okay. No. I'm just curious, you know,
your
attitude is so mercurial.
Right. Here we go. Michael, as Long John Silver was addressing the crew, his parrot blanked into his ear.
Whispered.
As you can tell from the groans, you got a winning answer there. All right, you got to match 5 celebrities to stay in the game. Pat, what have you got there?
He's not up to it.
He's not
so
up
I'll
to
it. Tell you, he said whispered.
Pat got one. Yay! Pat, speak to me, Pat. And you know, first aid, a little mouth-to-mouth resuscitation. Revive that man there. Pat got a match. That's impossible to believe there. Okay. Well done.
Are we off the air?
No, we're still out there. Brett, what did... That's your first aim bag. What did you say, Brett?
Who slapped me in the face?
That was...
Thanks, man.
Remember, I'm an officer.
I needed
and a lady.
That.
I've dated a lot of sailors in my day.
Yes.
And a lot of them had parrots. And they always bit into their ear.
Bit in the ear. Okay, no match there. That means you got to match everybody else to achieve a tie. Okay, Fitznipsey, we'll go on with it. What do you say?
In reading the vibrations of this audience, I'm beginning to think they have strange thoughts. I thought that parrot just shouted.
Shouted. Shouted is not whispered.
You know what I mean?
That means that Cindy wins again. Congratulations. Come on down, Cindy. Congratulations, $100 for you, and we'll get back to you in a moment or so. Sorry to say goodbye to Michael Schmidt. You've got a winning personality, a terrific
Thank
wardrobe,
you.
And you're a peachy kid and a good dancer. And you've won $1,200, and we thank you very much for being with
thank
us.
You.
Michael Schmidt. There he goes. Okay. Now, Cindy, you see this work, you know how it goes. You ready?
Yes, I am.
Here you go for the big ball game here. Now, we polled a recent studio audience and got the best response to this. Blank luck. The answer, you know how it goes, $500, $250, and $100. A little help from celebrities. Which ones do you want?
I'll try Fanny.
Fanny, how do you fill that blank in? Blank luck.
Pot luck.
Pot luck is one.
I have to try Brett.
Oh,
and
is
Brett?
She cute? How about Lady Luck?
Lady Luck.
Nipsey.
Nipsey?
Yes.
How do you fill in that blank? Blank luck.
Whisper.
Oh, luck. Let me see. How about lots of luck?
Lots of luck.
Lots.
So now, Cindy, you've got pot luck, lots of luck, and lady luck. You may choose one of those or think up one of your own. What would you like to do?
I'm going to have to use my own. I'm going to stay with good luck.
Yeah.
Good luck is the answer. All right, you're on your own. No help from the celebrities. Good luck is the answer she wants. Let's find out if it's up there. May we see the $100 response? Potluck is up there, the one that Fanny gave you. We still don't have good luck, and I hope you do get it. Let's see the $250 response. Lady Luck is up there, the one that Brent gave you. Third and last chance for good luck. Here is the $500 response. $500. Now you're going to play for 10 times that amount, or $5,000. And you've got to match one celebrity on a head-to-head basis. Which one will it be?
Richard.
All right, you get ready to write, and you face me if you would, please. And here is the $5,000 question. Richard, write your answer to this. Midnight blank. Midnight blank. Okay, he's finished his answer. Now we need a response from you. How do you fill in the blank? Midnight?
Cowboy.
Yay. Audience thinks he's got a winner there. Richard, for $5,000, may we see your answer?
Oh, that it were cowboy. Snack.
Cindy. Well, listen, you're still the champ. You're up to $600. You'll be playing another game, but first we've got to go along and do this message for you. Listen, you were just grand.
Yes.
But, folks, next week we will have this assortment of funny farm characters.
Bill Collins, Brett Somers, Charles Nelson Reilly, Patty Deutsch, Richard Dawson, and Betty White.
Gene Rayburn for Match Game 74. Join us next time.
This is Johnny Olson speaking for Match Game 74. A Mark Goodson, Bill Chapman production. Stay tuned for Tattletales next over most of the CBS stations.